Thank you very much. I thought I was get 1 minute to rebut something that Kaluyu kept on repeating here about the youth. I think one of the things that I will do about the youth is not to teach them dishonesty. Integrity is very important. On the 16th of July, before the first debate, all of us, 12 of us with our deputies, actually signed a document which was objecting in the manner in which this presidential debate was being structured. It was very unconstitutional, even in terms of just allocating the three of us here 90 minutes, and then the two people that you are waiting 90 minutes. That was unfair. And we signed a document that says, unless the debate is restructured to at least be equitable to us, we will not participate. Dr. Kaluyu here told the young person is trying to parade before here to disobey that agreement. That is dishonesty. You cannot lead a country if you do not respect what your peers and you agree. So that's one problem we have. Now to my closing remarks.
I will now grant you 90 seconds.
Thank you very much. Now,
so we can start the clock to 90 seconds.
As I close these remarks, I want to ask Kenyans for your vote. Because my candidature is not about power. It's about people. If you read the six pillars of our party, ending economic and social injustice, ending theft of public money, women and youth taking over government, protecting the constitution, rule of law, and placing Kenya into its competitive global agenda, it's about how do we transit this country into a first world country. We have got the best plans on how to change this country. But I also want to appeal to Kenyans, even as we go into this election, there cannot be any other country in the world than Kenya. I think this is the best country that we are given. And I want to remind Kenyans that in 1992, an incumbent was defending election, violence broke out in Rift Valley. In 1997, the same thing. In 2013, there was no incumbent defending election and we had a relatively peaceful election. In 2007, an incumbent was defending election and again, there was violence. I hope Kenyans in this 2017, whatever the outcome, we must keep this country intact. Now, I would like us to shun politics of tribalism because nobody eats tribe. If your rent is due at the end of this month, none of us will run to our tribes and say, I want rent, I want school fees for my children, I want health care. I think we have a very good country, a great country to be proud of. And I wish Kenyans would look into issues, into ideas, into what's the best plans. And I'm asking for your vote on August 8th, 2017. And I promise you, I'll implement each and every aspect of manifesto. And I have signed it as a commitment and promise to Kenyans.
Thank you very much.